10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Hello, Moto.
Tuesday night here on the West Coast, 10 p.m. We are live here on Radio Warp. Radio Warp Live, glad to have you along. And as we start this Tuesday night, I want to tell you a story. It's a story about someone I know and the dream that they had. Now, this dream would come at a cost, but the cost, he thought, would outweigh Or the benefit, I should say, would outweigh the cost. Now, this idea that he had, it would come with a lot of sacrifice, a lot of scrutiny. There would definitely be a lot of judgment. He would have to deal with a lot of negativity, harsh treatment. But again, he thought that the good would outweigh the bad. And so he pursued this idea. There were a lot of obstacles, a lot of challenges, but along the journey, there were also a lot of good things that came about. A lot of people started to support him and his idea of what he wanted to do. They came alongside. A lot of people succeeded. There was some failure. Like anybody that does anything, you're going to experience failure. You're going to experience the highs and the lows of life as they come your way. But if you have an idea of something that you want to do, no matter what it is that you want to do, you're going to chase it. You're going to chase that passion, and you're going to overcome those obstacles, and you're going to forget about the naysayers and the negativity, and you're going to focus on the job at hand and get the job done. Now, this guy went through a tremendous time while he was pursuing his goal and his dream. A lot of sacrifice to his family. A lot of people making things up and telling lies. Now, the guy wasn't an angel, that's for sure. Who is? Had a lot of problems, a lot of baggage. But don't we all learn from our experiences? I mean, isn't that what makes us who we are, the things that we go through? Our life experiences, we either grow from them or we're going to let them defeat us. And sometimes people will get defeated by their goals or their dreams, and they have to settle for something because they don't have them in them. And then when they see somebody else get success, they want to be jealous and they want to tear down somebody because they were able to achieve their goals and they were able to achieve what they were able to get because they had it in them to go after it regardless of the obstacles, regardless of anything that was going to be in this way, be in your way, be in my way, and take on that task and really achieve something. And so from the moment that this person decided to take those initial steps to pursue this dream, this goal, there was a lot of resistance along the way. But in the end, the experience that he went through, the experience and all the things that he learned, all the things that he was able to achieve, everything that he did, he looked back upon those accomplishments. He looked back upon maybe the failures, looked back upon all the things that he went through, the cost to his family, the cost to himself. But he never gave up on that dream. And in the end, when it was all said and done, the parting words that he had to say was this.
If I give you one message to hold in your hearts today, it's this. Treat the word impossible as nothing more than motivation. Relish the opportunity to be an outsider, because it's the outsiders who change the world and who make a real and lasting difference. The more that a broken system tells you that you're wrong, the more certain you should be that you must keep pushing ahead. You must keep pushing forward.
Now, if you listen with partisan ears tonight, you might miss out on something. It is the eve of the inauguration of a new president. But think back 4 years ago. Would you be able to withstand everything that he went through? Would you be able to hold up to that scrutiny, to have the fortitude in you to fight back? How many times do we sit there on social media and we engage with somebody that has an opposite view than us? And then maybe you, or maybe the other person, in my case, a lot of times it's the other person, they just give up. I end up getting blocked. They don't have the fortitude to stick with their convictions. And so as we go through the night, it's not all about politics. In fact, it has nothing to do with politics tonight, but it has everything to do with the idea of the impossible. Don't give up. We're going to hear words from a lot of different people here tonight. In fact, we've got an interview coming up a little bit later that is going to talk about a dream that this person had and how he was able to chase that dream and what it took for him. But as we go through the night, think of all the times that you had an opportunity maybe to chase your goal, chase your dreams. Were you able to get them? Or was there something that kept you from achieving that goal? For many years, I was teaching at a community college in the radio broadcasting department. A lot of students came through the program, a lot of them young, wide-eyed, eager to be the next superstar, maybe the next Ryan Seacrest, or maybe the next Jim Rome, maybe the next Howard Stern, Rush Limbaugh. Insert any superstar in there. And yet when push came to shove, when they realized what it took, the sacrifice, it took more than they were willing to give. It took having to overcome maybe some criticism from their family. You know, you should really be out there getting a job right now and making money, because this radio thing isn't going to pay off. You take a look at all those people that kind of, they came in with the drive and the goal. That was their desire. But yet all the negative, they succumbed to. I don't fault them for that. I don't blame them for that. But think about what it takes to make it. And you think about what the president has done the last 4 years. I mean, from the moment he came down the escalator, it was him against the world. And at the end of it, 75 million people support the guy. So much so that you have people out there calling for a deprogrammed society. We need to deprogram these people. But look at the devotion this guy created. And people would call it a cult. People would call it many different things. But maybe the mere fact that he put them first, something strange and bizarre in the world of politics, something strange and bizarre in the world that we live in, putting somebody else first. Sure, he wanted to be president. Who doesn't? As far as the idea goes of wanting to be the president and wanting to have that name and that recognition and that power and that influence, everybody that runs for it wants it. The narcissist in them wants them to become the president. But in the end, what is it? What's the message? And the message we get tonight is the impossible can be overcome. We can achieve the things that we want to if we can set our mind to it. It might not be an easy road. In fact, the road is often difficult. The road of life is often difficult. We found that out in 2020. People calling for, when are we going to return to normal? And then others, no, it's a new normal. But is life ever normal? We live inside this box that society tells us that we need to live in. We need to graduate from high school. Probably a good idea. We need to go off to college and get a degree. That's sound advice. Then maybe we need to get a master's degree, because that'll just set us apart from everybody else. Then we need to find a job, a career-minded job maybe. something that we can stay at for the next 20, 30 years. And then we retire. And along the way, maybe we fall in love and have a family. Maybe we buy that house with the white picket fence and the 2.3 kids and a couple of rescued dogs. And that's how we live life. And that's how we're taught. The dream, the American dream. But then along the way, things unexpectedly, like a virus, will completely upend that. Working in the entertainment field, the media field, think back to 2009, when we had an economic crisis that killed a lot of TV shows, ended a lot of radio careers, a lot of people in the entertainment business lost their jobs because of the economic downturn of 2009. And then people came back. They rebuilt. The industry, they kind of thought, what can we do to make things maybe more less expensive? And then you have the American Idols, the Masked Singers, The Voice, and all those shows came out. The high production valued shows kind of went away, those dramas for a while that led and opened the door to America's Got Talent and things like that. And so they adjusted. They maybe saw an obstacle, tried to figure out a solution, and went around that solution. And came up with something that now a lot of people really enjoy. They enjoy watching these shows. And so that's what it's about. It's in your life. What is it that you want to achieve? Do you have it in you to go after it? Do you have what it takes to maybe overcome the obstacles? To fight? Is impossible in your vocabulary? Do you surrender to the impossible? Do we all get to achieve our dreams? No. But can we come close? Can we do something that maybe we didn't think we could do, and therefore we set out to do it? Could that be at any time? Could it be now? Maybe you're dealing with, it's 2021, it's a new year, 2020 sucked, and so, you know what? I want to make a change. But then you start to think, well, you know, maybe I'm in my 50s, maybe I'm in my 60s, you know, I really should finish college. Maybe I need to do this. And so you start to throw obstacles in front of you and you start to realize that, wait a minute, I can't achieve what I want to do. So then maybe you settle for something and then maybe life becomes miserable. There was an interview, I guess you could say, but it was a night where this guy that I'm going to play here in a minute, they were asking him some questions about what it takes to be successful and what are some of the key things that he was able to do to become successful. And so this is Kobe Bryant talking about what's the first thing that he looked for in himself for something that he wanted to do.
Follow your passion first. And you got to sit there and ask yourself, okay, what am I truly passionate about? What do I enjoy doing? And when you feel that way, you feel like you have never worked a day in your life. It's the most fun thing in the world. You get up in the morning excited about what you're doing. And you got to be really honest with yourself about it. If you wake up in the morning and you're dreading going to work, dude, do something else. Do something else. And those are hard decisions to make. But when you make those decisions, it's a very liberating experience. And you find out that the rewards will come.
Passion. It's all about the passion. Do you have passion in you to go after something that you want to do? Are you living inside that box where society is telling you you need to be? I often like to use the analogy, especially in the classroom. You have a big whiteboard because there's no longer chalkboards, but you have a big whiteboard and you draw a box on the whiteboard. And I demonstrate this is where people want you to live, inside this box. But look at the whiteboard. That's beyond the box. There's so much out there. We're taught to color within the lines, but you know, sometimes it takes us coloring outside the lines or going outside the lines to find out what we want to do and to figure out exactly how to get there. Here's another soundbite. Take a listen to this and see if this rings true.
One of the most important things, never, ever quit. Never quit. You know, I went to a great school. I went to the Wharton School of Finance. And in that school, I met a lot of people heading industry today and over the past, very smart people. But I've watched some of the people grow. I've watched some of the most incredible, brilliant students. And they didn't make it like other people made it because they didn't have that drive. They didn't have that never give up ability. I don't know if it's an ability or if you have it. Just you can't quit. And I've seen people quitting. And if they would have held out longer, they would have been successful. I've seen it so much. I've seen some of the most brilliant people in the world that never made it because they were quitters. They were just quitters. They would quit. They just couldn't take it. They couldn't whatever. One of the things about loving what you do is that it's not work, and therefore you don't quit automatically. It's a lot easier not to quit. But you can never give up. Now, you have to also have flexibility, though. You can't necessarily say, I'm never giving up. And you got to be able to weave and bob. You don't have to go through a concrete wall when you can go over it or around it or under it or something. You have to have flexibility. You have to always be able to change course a little bit, maybe always with that same goal, but don't quit.
There's a theme running through tonight, the sound bites that you're going to hear. And again, take your partisan ears and set them aside and listen to what's being said. Don't quit. There's an obstacle in the way. How are you going to get around it? I mean, we take a look at a lot of people, for example. Let's just talk about American Idol. American Idol came about because of some of the things that were going on in Hollywood and the economics at the time. They needed to find a cheaper production and still provide entertainment. And so American Idol was one of those shows that kind of came out of that idea. What can we do to entertain the masses, cut production costs, and still provide something that people will want to watch? So the economy was the big brick wall or the big stone in the way. They tunneled under it. They went around it. They went over it. They found a way to find something. And American Idol became a huge hit. Kelly Clarkson went on to have a big career. Now she has a TV show. I believe she was the first winner from season one. So people went on American Idol to try to make it big, and a lot of people did. Some failed. Some won, and some failed. They became the season winner and went on to do nothing. But take a look at Hillary Scott. She went on. She's the lead singer for what was Lady Antebellum. I guess we now call them Lady A. She went on there and she never made it. She failed. But she went on to form Lady A or Lady Antebellum at the time. And now everybody, if you follow country music, maybe pop music, you know who they are. Quite successful. She never gave up her dream just because Simon Cowell said she couldn't sing. She got over that obstacle and went and found her dream and made it happen. Again, you think of Jordan Sparks. She was the winner of season 6 of American Idol. Now, she didn't get out of the first audition. She failed. First audition. Never made it to the judges round. But then she won a contest on a radio station, so she was able to re-enter, go through the process again, eventually got in front of the judges, and she won season 6. Well, how about this? Let's get out of the music world, out of the entertainment world. What about business? Think about this. Colonel Sanders, does that name sound familiar? Kentucky Fried Chicken, maybe now you know it as KFC. So here was a guy in his mid-60s, and all he had was a dream, a recipe, and $105 in a Social Security check. That's it. He sets out to try to accomplish a dream. He approaches many restaurants. In fact, there were 1,009 rejections before somebody finally said yes. And KFC went on to become KFC, what it is today. And all it was a dream, a recipe, and $105. Dr. Seuss, Sam I Am, Sam I Am. I do not like that Sam I Am. Green Eggs and Ham. His first book, I believe it was, And to Think I Saw It on Mulberry Street. It was rejected 28 times. And at the time of his death, the book had sold over 600 million copies and was written in 20 different languages, but rejected 28 times. How many times are we rejected the first time and then we give up? The obstacle's too big. I can't get around it. I don't know what to do. It's easy to get discouraged. It's a natural emotion. It's easy to be dejected. That's a natural emotion. I mean, after all, when you think about athletes, teams coming out into the basketball court, the music's pumping. You got the big inspirational speech from the coach. Tommy Lasorda recently passed away. Lifelong Dodger, bled Dodger blue. As a manager, he won 1,599 games. He lost 1,439, so he only won 2% more than he lost. He had a winning percentage of 52%. In the postseason, he won 31 games, lost 30, about even. But he did win two championships. And because of that, because he stuck with it, because 50% in most circles is considered mediocre or average at best, right? But what does Mark Cuban, business magnate, owner of the basketball team from the NBA, the Dallas Mavericks, what does he have to say? And how does that fit in with maybe Tommy Lasorda and what he was able to accomplish with only a 52% winning record?
You just have to try different things, and even if 99% of them fail, you only have to be right one time. You don't have to figure it all out in advance. You can be wrong. You can pick the wrong career. You can pick the wrong job. You can pick the wrong spouse. You can pick the wrong whatever. But you get it right one time, you're set. But if you don't try, and if you don't go out there and try all those different things, you'll never get that one time. And so it's not a question of, okay, how much different stuff do I do, or how many different things should you try? Try them all. Try them all until you find the one you like. And then it's like, it gets really easy, because even when shit fucks up, you're on a mission. You're loving what you do.
You're on a mission. You're loving what you do. Things go bad. Things go wrong, but you're on a mission. You're out there to become the best you. Your passion. Take your passion. Make it happen. Let yourself be great. That's what we should have in all of us. Don't settle for mediocrity. Granted, life comes along and throws us a few curveballs. But then what do? Maybe then we have to change a little bit what we want to achieve, because life happens. COVID happens. Things that we didn't expect. Normal life of going through my career, getting my house, my picket fence, my 2.5 kids, a couple rescue dogs, and my Pontiac. It upsets things. It upsets the apple cart. But yet, do we rebound? Do we regroup? Do we go after it again? Because stuff will happen. And it only takes that one time. We're one failure away from success. Do we stop when that last failure, so we miss success? Are we going to go after it? And you can only you can define success for yourself. Only you can define certain things. I mean, we think about travel, flight. You think about Kitty Hawk. When the Wright brothers first took flight, probably wasn't anything, well, to them, it was probably pretty cool, but it probably wasn't anything majestic like we might see today. But it was a start. It was a start for something that eventually led to man on the moon. Flight. It started somewhere. It started with one thing. And it went from there. And sometimes we might be the person that plants the seed. We might be the one person that gets something going. One failure away from success. Don't quit. Don't give up. We've got to try. We've got to fail. Get knocked down. Get back up. Never going to keep you down. You think about, again, using a sports analogy, I think of all the baseball players that had the talent to make it big. They had the ability, but yet they did not, because the drive in them just wasn't quite there. Homesickness set in, and that's natural. That's okay. But they just couldn't overcome it. They didn't have it in them. They had so much talent, so much ability, but the tangibles, they just couldn't get over. It wasn't in them. So they couldn't make it to the big leagues. Some might see that as failure. But what did they do then? Where did they go from there? Did they go on to coach high school sports and impact the lives of many high school ball players that they might not have if they had gone pro? Were they able to teach in the classroom? Were they able to go into the business world and impact others? See, success in the minds of the individual, success for us, is going to be different from societal success. Society is going to tell us that success is money, is fame, it's riches, it's power. I mean, we see it all the time. We see it through the political leaders. We see it through the celebrities, through athletes. You know, these people that have a lot of money and a lot of power, life doesn't affect them like it does the rest of us, the average Joe on the street trying to make it big. I mean, think about your educational situation, your educational experience. One of the things that I had to be careful about when I was teaching was to not shatter the dreams of people, because I didn't know if they were going to make it or not. Maybe they did. There were many times someone would come into the classroom and I would look at them and be like, wow, this person has it. They're going to go all the way. They're going to be the next superstar. And then something comes up and they don't. But then over the course of a couple years, as a student goes through the program, I never really noticed them early on, but I start to realize their potential. And after a year of classes, I'm like, wait a minute, this person that I never even looked at in the beginning, the one that didn't come in highly recruited, the one that didn't have all the bells and whistles, but this person put in the time, worked hard, started to perfect his or her craft, started to do the little things. And the next thing you know, these people are now like, wait, they're doing a good show. They've got talent. They've got the ability. And they're the ones that rise to the top. They're the ones that go out there. They're the ones that make it big, have the success. Because it's not always about the package. It's about the person inside them. The package, I mean, what do we do at Christmas time? We rip off the package and we go for what's inside. And so we can't really judge somebody based on how they are because we don't know. It's going to take a while for us to figure out what that person is. So if we are someone that is maybe influencing somebody else, we need to make sure that we don't reject or neglect people that we might be able to come alongside and maybe help reach their goal. Give them what they need, that extra boost, that extra inspiration, that motivation to get them to where they need to go. I think of FedEx, you know, FedEx, the shipping company. And the owner of FedEx went to some Ivy League school, maybe Yale, I don't know. And for his business project, he had to put together something, a project that was basically start a business and let's see what you can do. So he comes up with the concept of FedEx. And so his professor looks at the project, looks at his paper, goes through all the business proposal plans and everything. And the professor decides that FedEx is going to fail. Bankruptcy. Well, we know who was right and who was wrong in that situation. The FedEx guy did not give up. He did not let a professor tell him that his goal, his dream, what he had envisioned was going to stop him from doing what he did. And now it's FedEx. Think about Amazon. Do you remember how Amazon started? The dreaded Amazon. Jeff Bezos. The devil himself. Start out with books. If you read his story, he had an opportunity when he first started Amazon many years ago. He was looking at a few different items. Books were one of them. CDs were another. And then there are a few other options. But he felt that the best chance for success was looking at books, dealing with books. We think of it now as like the big online shopping retail center, right? But it started with books, dealing in books. And it went from there. And he took his goal, he took his vision, he took his dream, and he expanded it. And now Amazon is what it is. How about this? Remember Stan Lee, the guy that created all kinds of comic books and things like that? Remember when comic books were bad? I don't know about you, but you know, comic books were always, at least in my circle, kind of a waste of time. Maybe they weren't understood. You know, Archie, I think it was Mad Magazine that probably gave comic books, that type of thing, in my circle is probably a bad eye. But here's what Stan Lee has to say.
If there is something that you feel is good, something you want to do, something that means something to you, try to do it. Because I think you can only do your best work if you're doing what you want to do and if you're doing it the way you think it should be done.
Stan Lee, one of the most successful people that we could probably think of in the entertainment world. All the movies, all the comic books, all the cameos that he made. And he was talking about you, not with somebody else. Here, let's play it again and see what he had to say again. It's about you.
If there is something that you feel is good, something you want to do, something that means something to you, try to do it. Because I think you can only do your best work if you're doing what you want to do and if you're doing it the way you think it should be done.
About 9 references there to you and your. And that's what it comes down to. It comes down to your success. Can you do it? You know, oftentimes we sit there and we have to deal with people that are doubters. It could be parents. It could be siblings. It could be friends. That was one of the biggest obstacles that I had to fight with students. Students would come in and they'd love the radio program. They'd want to be, you know, the next superstar. So they're chasing their dream, but their parents, their family, not supporting them. I was always fortunate to have supportive parents. Maybe we have to tune out the negative, get away from those doubters. Maybe try to find people around us that can help build us up. Be reasonable, not just feed us this fantasy, but be reasonable. Get influencers in us. Maybe we're the ones that need to be the influence. You know, maybe we're a couple of steps ahead in life and there's some people coming behind us. And we've been there. Experience means a lot of things to people. Imagine the experience that you have, the information that you can give to somebody to help them out. It'd be completely different. Maybe you make the impact in their lives. Maybe you're the one that makes a change. Or you come up with that idea and you have the boldness to speak it at work. Maybe you come up with something that might better your product, better productivity. Maybe you better yourself, but you're afraid to because you're afraid of what other people are going to think. You know, fashion is one of the things that if people know me, they know I'm not into fashion. I pretty much wear the same thing, just a couple different versions of color, but pretty much the same thing. But I think Albert Einstein pretty much had the same suit, just had maybe 10 different of the same suit. And he was a genius, so I like to think myself as a genius. But maybe when it comes to fashion, there's people out there that they wear different types of things. And then there's some that are kind of, they have the attitude for it. They're flamboyant. They don't care what they wear. And they like it, and they're going to wear it, regardless of what people say. And then there's others that are a little bit more timid and shy, and they want to take a fashion maybe take a fashion trend and own it, but maybe their attitude, their perspective is a little bit shy. And so they're kind of a little afraid. You ever know somebody like that they want to try something, maybe a new hairstyle, a haircut, but they're just not sure if it's going to be them. And so they just stay status quo. Maybe they need someone to push them over the edge to be like, you know what? You can do this. So take a shot, take a chance. Here was somebody that, was a basketball coach. Unfortunately, he succumbed to cancer. His name was Jim Valvano. He was with North Carolina State back in 1983. His North Carolina State Wolfpack in college basketball took on the mighty Houston Cougars. Houston was at the time the elite basketball program. They had Hakeem Olajuwon and Clyde Drexler, both that went on to play in the NBA, plus a couple others. And they actually won the national championship. But here's something that he said. He was at the ESPY Awards, and he was riddled with tumors. It took a lot to get him there, but he had one of the most inspirational speeches to that time, and probably still to this day. It was one of the probably one of those speeches that people who are going to have a motivational or inspirational speech would probably go to and listen for inspiration to write their inspirational or their motivational speech. But he had one thing in there, a short little clip that made an impact and makes an impact still today. And this is what it was. This is what he said at the ESPYs. He had, I think, like a 20-minute speech. And it was funny because he's sitting there, and of course, you know, like any award show, it's on TV, it's live. And so you have people directing and telling, you know, the celebrities or the people that are speaking, hey, you've only got a few minutes, you know, 30 seconds left, 15 seconds left. They're counting them down to the break. And it was funny because Jim Valvano sat there and the guy's trying to wave to him, tell him 30 seconds. And Jim Valvano says, you know, my body's riddled with tumors. Do you think the guy waving me for 30 seconds left is going to matter? Not dismissing him, but things were bigger than life at that point. Life was bigger than that commercial break because he had a message to send, and that message was to motivate people despite the cancer that was eating him away. And in the end, this was the biggest impact that he had to say for people. This is what people remember his speech to be.
Don't give up. Don't ever give up. Cancer can take away all my physical abilities. It cannot touch my mind. It cannot touch my heart. And it cannot touch my soul. And those three things are going to carry on forever.
Don't give up. Don't give up. That's the message here tonight. Don't give up. Chase your dreams. Take your passion. Make it happen. Again, we're on the eve of an inauguration, and a lot of people are celebrating. Celebrating the fact that one of the most hated men in our country history is leaving office. That's what they're celebrating. But they don't realize what he achieved and what he accomplished. He took on the establishment. He chased his dream, and he won it, and he got it. And he sat in the White House for 4 years when nobody gave him a chance. And 75 million people today who voted for him in the last election thought he did a great job. You can't do that just by being somebody who's soft and weak. You have to be strong. And that's the message for you. Be strong in whatever it is you're doing. You're fighting things. You're fighting an obstacle. It's called life. Life, there's going to be good times. There's going to be bad times. But it's going to hit you. And what do you do? Do you rise up or do you just wilt away?
I've seen so many brilliant people. They gave up in life. They were totally brilliant. They were top of their class. They were the best students. They were the best of everything. They gave up. I've seen others who really didn't have that talent or that ability. And they're among the most successful people today in the world because they never quit and they never gave up. So just remember that. Never stop fighting for what you believe in and for the people who care about you. Carry yourself with dignity and pride. Demand the best from yourself.
There were people that weren't the most talented. There were people that didn't have the greatest skill. There's people out there that are probably more talented than I am, than you are. People out there that could probably do a lot more than we ever could, but they don't have it in them. Maybe they lost their way. Maybe that's what happened to the president. He lost his way. I don't know. But there's a way that we can, in our life, take our passion, make it happen. We can be the influence, the positive influence to help others achieve that same goal. Not give up. Not give up on life. I think about Freddie Mercury. There's about a 20-minute video on YouTube, and I kind of forget the name offhand, but it's about his final days. And they had a song that the drummer of the band wrote for him, for himself and his kid, and Freddie Mercury heard it. And after talking with him and the band, they decided to make it Freddie Mercury's swan song. And Freddie Mercury was there, and they were doing the video. And as you watch the, it's like the Days of Our Lives or something like that. Just type in Freddie Mercury, Days of Our Lives, Best Days of Our Lives, and it'll pop up. But it's pretty inspirational because despite who he was and despite what he did in life, at the end of it, when he was sitting there dying from AIDS, he would get up every day, he would go to the studio, and he would have his couple shots of vodka, he'd stand by the piano, they would roll tape, and he would film the video for it. And he put his all into it. Again, somebody dying of AIDS, his passion, he got up out of bed, and then a few days later, he passed away. That's the drive that he had in him for his passion. Now, we may not have that, and that's okay. You got to find it within you. We can't compare ourselves to other people. We'd like to. Society tells us to. Sometimes people will tell us to. But it's all about us. It's about us as an individual, and we have to remember that as we see others. As we interact with others, realize that they're not us, we're not them, they're not anybody else, they're unique. We're all snowflakes. And I don't mean that in the soft way, you know, where we're just all, oh, there's a snowflake, oh, he's weak. No, we're individuals. We're each unique unto ourselves. We're created that way. Maybe you know this guy, Steve Jobs. Here's what he had to say on this.
People say you have to have a lot of passion for what you're doing, and it's totally true. And the reason is because it's so hard that if you don't, any rational person would give up. It's really hard, and you have to do it over a sustained period of time. So if you don't love it, if you're not having fun doing it, you don't really love it, you're going to give up. And that's what happens to most people, actually. If you really look at the ones that ended up, you know, being successful, unquote, in the eyes of society, and the ones that didn't, oftentimes it's the ones that are successful loved what they did so they could persevere when, you know, when it got really tough. And the ones that didn't love it quit because they're sane, right? Who would want to put up with this stuff if you don't love it? So it's a lot of hard work, and it's a lot of worrying constantly. And if you don't love it, you're going to fail. So you got to love it. You got to have passion.
You catch the theme? You've got to have the passion for what we do, whatever it is we're doing. And sometimes that might be a hard choice to make, giving up the security and the comfort and moving out, expanding ourselves beyond that box that society tells us to live in. When you think of people that are movie stars, you think about the movies that you watch, what name comes to mind? What actor or actress could someone say, hey, do you want to watch this movie starring? Maybe it's Kevin Costner. Anytime Kevin Costner has a movie come on or a movie come out that he's a part of, or maybe Clint Eastwood, for me, there's a good chance that I'll probably sit down and watch it just because I know their body of work and what they've done, and they usually put out good movies. But how about this? Keanu Reeves. He is probably by far one of the celebrities that is just very mild-mannered, doesn't really live in the limelight, but highly famous, highly successful. People know his name. You think back to, you know, Wild Stallions and those movies, running around San Dimas, and then most recently you get, you know, The Matrix and then John Wick and all the other movies he's done. He was a guy that had a lot of hardship growing up. At the age of 3, his father abandoned his family. His mother was married and divorced like 4 separate times, moved around the world. Finally, he ends up in Los Angeles. 1998, he fathered a child with his then wife. The baby died as a stillborn, 8 months. After that, the relationship ended. His ex-wife was then killed in a car accident. A lot of tragedy there for a guy, for anybody to take on. I mean, that's a lot. Think about it. You've got an unsettled, like, parent situation. You're traveling all around the world, probably no roots. A loss of a child, which I couldn't even fathom what that would be like. Have a little bit of a glimpse. For those of you that know my story, my friend Chris died when he was 17. And so seeing that through the eyes of his parents, I can understand it a little bit, but I'll never understand that. Ex-wife being killed in a car crash, and because of the loss, probably that grief just never allowed them to stay together. I mean, that's a lot of tragedy, but he was able to overcome that. And I think that's what keeps him humble. He was able to not give up. How easy could it have been for him? And when you listen to him and you listen to him tell stories about, you know, whatever it is he's talking about, whatever the interview might be, he always has this humbleness to him. But yet he goes out there, he gives it his all. He puts everything into those movies. Had an opportunity one time to interview Kevin Costner, and he'd said the same thing. It was about his passion that he put into the film. It was the little details. It wasn't just the big things that mattered. It was the way you walked into the room. Kevin Costner would describe the importance of walking into a room a certain way to set the tone. And then the tone would set the scene. It was that passion. And he'd have him redo it over and over and over again until it was just right. I think Val Kilmer, I think it was The Saint, talking about how the sweatshirt or the sweater that he was wearing in one of the scenes toward the end of the movie had to be just so. And so they sent out the costume people to find just that perfect sweater for maybe one scene. But it mattered. The attention to detail, the passion to make it happen, the way they wanted to see it, the way they wanted to do it. You know, we're influenced by a lot of people. We're influenced by a lot of things. Social media influences us. TV influences us. Pop culture, music, all influences us. Influences us the way to think, the way to feel, the way we should react. I believe we're a society that likes to be told what to think and when to think it. I think that's what we're becoming. We like to be told what to do, when to do it. I mean, it's pretty obvious when you just step back and look at society and what's going on and how people are reacting. I'll let you decide whether that's good or bad. But if we turn that off and we change the influences in our lives, if we change the people that we look to, if we change the way we approach things, if we just look at things a little different, then maybe we can have a better perspective on how to chase our dreams, how to overcome our obstacles. I got another soundbite. It's supposed to be Steve Harvey, so I hope I hit the right button.
You will never succeed more than you fail. That's not how it works. You know why? Because failure is a wonderful teacher. It's the only way to learn. You have to fail. Failure is a part of the process to becoming successful. I tell people this all the time. Michael Jordan, the greatest basketball player in the world, he took 946 game-winning shots. He has missed over 700 times, but he has made 146. You know what they write about? When he make it. They write about when you make it. So guess what? When you get through failing, 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 all you got to do is make one. Shit, who you know that gets it right all the time? That's impossible. You have to fail. Matter of fact, when you fail, be glad about it. Every time you fail, you're one step closer.
There again, Steve Harvey talking about that one time. Mark Cuban said just that one time. That's all you need is one time. Embrace the failure. When you fail, you just find out another way how it's not going to work. And these are successful people. Steve Harvey, Steve Jobs, Mark Cuban, even Donald Trump, though you may hate him. Successful people telling you don't quit, don't give up, overcome those obstacles. And as we embark on the new year and a new change, maybe that's something we can look at in ourselves. Be the change that we want to be. You know, there's oftentimes I get engaged in arguments on social media. People advise me not to, but sometimes it's just too amusing to pass up. Others call it gaslighting. I'll take that. Some say I like to get down in the weeds and sling arrows. Okay, if that's what you want to call it. Sometimes it's just fun. Sometimes it's challenging. Challenging to try not to make it personal and keep on the topic. And then in the end, it's forgotten. We move on, the next post. But when it comes to, and for me, social media, like I've said before, it's really not real. It's you know, if you've watched the Social Dilemma on Netflix, the documentary, then you'll really start to understand what social media really is. And people take it as gospel, but really it's just a ploy to control our lives. But that's another topic for another story, another day. But again, when you're dealing with the new year, the new change, with change comes fear. With change comes uncertainty. But we don't have to let those people outside of us, those bad influences, those naysayers, the negativity affect us. It might be a part of what we do in life, but we don't have to let it affect us. We can be the change that we want to see. We can do whatever it is we want to do if we set our minds to it. Here's a clip from a movie, Morgan Freeman. And it's kind of interesting. It doesn't really fit in completely with that whole idea of not giving up and taking your passion and making it happen. But what he talks about here is something that's interesting when you look at it through the perspective of opportunity. And here's what he had to say.
Let me ask you something. If someone prays for patience, do you think God gives them patience? Or does he give them the opportunity to be patient? If they prayed for courage, does God give them courage, or does he give them opportunities to be courageous? If someone prayed for the family to be closer, do you think God zaps them with warm, fuzzy feelings? Or does he give them opportunities to love each other?
We need to look for those opportunities. We need to look for those opportunities to take our passion, make it happen. Let ourselves be great, as defined by us. Some of the greatest things that we could be is a parent, a sibling, a friend. You ask any mother, they'll probably say their greatest reward in life is their kid or kids or children. Remember that whole idea of that stay-at-home mom? It almost had like a negative connotation. Oh, what do you do? Well, I'm a business executive. I run IBM. I have a cash account, an expense account, and I travel the world. Oh, that's great. What do you do? I'm a stay-at-home mom. Oh, really? Okay. No. Being a parent, being a mother, one of the greatest rewards you can have is children. And that's who you're influencing. That's your passion. You're making it happen. You're raising up the next generation. You're a teacher. You're in the classroom. Being a teacher these days is hard with online learning and everything that's going on. It's a difficult job, but you're there influencing people. You're educating them. You're making them learn. How are you going to take that? And how are you going to influence those kids? Is it going to be for the good to make them? Because you got to realize that those kids are going to be the ones that take care of us when we get old. How do we want them to take care of us? Do you want to end up just in some retirement home somewhere, forgotten? Or do we want them to have the passion of life that we had? Think about how America got here through the industrial age, the vision that people had, the determination. Think of any great structure, the Golden Gate Bridge, the monuments in D.C. How about the railroad? You look at all these great things that took place. The Hoover Dam. The vision that it took. The sacrifice that it took. It took a lot. You think if people just gave up, where would we be today? What would we be doing? If we just let other people rule and dictate our lives, how's that going to be? It's another sound clip I want to play. So here it is.
Look at the way I've been treated lately, especially by the media. No politician in history has been treated worse or more unfairly. You can't let them get you down. You can't let the critics and the naysayers get in the way of your dreams. Adversity makes you stronger. Don't give in. Don't back down and never stop doing what you know is right. Nothing worth doing ever, ever, ever came easy. And the more righteous your fight, the more opposition that you will face.
Nothing ever came easy. It's a fight. Do we have it in us? Do we have it in us to overcome the things that it will take for us to make that change, be that person? You know, you take a look at Walt Disney. If you live in California, you're probably, and you're a big Disney fan, you're probably itching to get back to the Magic Kingdom. Ride the rides, hit Space Mountain. That's my personal favorite. Maybe go and sing along with It's a Small World. If you don't know the lyrics, probably should learn them. Or what about the Pirates of the Caribbean? Nothing like singing a little yo-ho, yo-ho, A Pirate's Life for me. Walt Disney, you look at him now and he was a genius, a creative genius. You think of Mickey Mouse, the ears. Donald Duck. Think of Snow White. And all the things that he created. The Walt Disney Company. What a legacy. He was not without failure. His company, Laugh-O-Gram, nobody knows about that. It went bankrupt. It took him 5 years to overcome that. Ups and downs, a lot of heartache. And then it hit the mouse. Mickey Mouse came along. Then success came. Steamboat Willie. And now it's the empire that it is. He had a vision. He did not let And look at the impact he has on everybody today. I mean, think about it. Disneyland, how much joy it brings people. Probably brings a lot of parents some sorrow when the bank account hits. But think about the amount of people he impacts. It's an escape. It's fantasy. It's fun. We go to the Magic Kingdom. We forget about all of our problems. We can't wait to get that fast pass to go on the ride. Avoid the 8-hour wait for Space Mountain. Walk up and down Main Street. Get our ice cream from the Carnation Ice Cream Shop. See the fireworks display go off at night over the castle. Enjoy getting wet at Splash Mountain. All those fun things. If he had given up, we would not have that today. So the whole point of this is to remember, don't give up. Whatever it is that you want to do, don't give up. Don't let the obstacles get in your way and stop you. Try. Don't be afraid of failure. We heard from many successful people tonight. Failure's okay. Embrace failure. Expect it. Rebound from it. Learn from it. Take that experience, go back to the drawing board, and come up with something better. Take your passion, make it happen, let yourself be great. We are one failure away from success. Are you going to stop on that failure? Or are you going to try one more time, that one more time? Mark Cuban said, one more time, try it, try anything. Trump, go around the obstacles, up, over it, whatever. Don't let the naysayers stop you from doing what you want to do. You don't have to be the most successful person. You don't have to have the greatest talent. You don't have to be the superstar. You just have to have it in you that you have a goal, a vision, whatever it is, and you're going to go after it, and you're going to do it no matter what. It might take change. It might take moving around a little bit. It might take trying a different course, but you're going to do it. It could be something as simple as the new year, we're going to get in shape, going to lose weight. You can do it. Might be starting a new career, a new job. You can do it. It might be starting all over, moving away. You can do it. You have to define in you what it is that you want. You have to define in you what it is that you want to achieve, how you're going to go after it. It's probably wise to bring some people along with you for support, but the people that are going to support you truly and honestly, give you honest feedback, give you honest perspective on things. But then you're going to go after it and you're going to have to decide, do you have it in you to do that? Don't live inside that box. No matter what you are, how old you are, what you've been doing. Don't live inside that box. If there's something inside you that's telling you to go do something, go do it. Go after it. Because as we've learned from all these people, from Kobe Bryant to Steve Jobs and all in between, life is a lot more fun when we are involved in what we are passionate about. And that's what it comes down to. Taking our passion, making it happen, and letting ourselves be great. Don't give up. Go after it. And that's the message for tonight. I know I said earlier there's going to be an interview, but I guess we'll have to do that another time, which is cool because I think it was good to have this conversation. So for those of you listening, thanks for listening. Do tell a friend. Truly appreciate it. We'll be back here again next Tuesday, 10 p.m. Pacific time. Take your passion, make it happen. Let yourself be great. Don't give up. Failure's okay. Embrace it. Keep trying because you are one failure away from success. You guys have a great week and we will see you. Or I guess you won't see me. I guess you'll hear me, but we'll be together again next, Tuesday night, 10 p.m. Pacific time, right here on RadioWarp.com.
If I give you one message to hold in your hearts today, it's this. Treat the word impossible as nothing more than motivation. Relish the opportunity to be an outsider because it's the outsiders who change the world and who make a real and lasting difference. The more that a broken system tells you that you're wrong, the more certain you should be that you must keep pushing ahead. You must keep pushing forward.